You can roughly locate any community in the world somewhere along a scale running all the way from democracy to despotism. One at a democracy end, another somewhere in the middle, and a third. Let's find out about despotism. This man makes it his job to study these things.
Well, for one thing, avoid the comfortable idea that the mere form of government can of itself safeguard a nation against despotism. Germany, under President Hindenburg, was a republic. And yet in this republic, an aggressive despotism took root and flourished under Adolf Hitler. When a competent observer looks for signs of despotism in a community, he looks beyond fine words and noble phrases.
One nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Many observers have found that two workable yardsticks help in discovering how near a community is to despotism: the respect scale and the power scale.
A careful observer can use a respect scale to find how many citizens get an even break. As a community moves towards despotism, respect is restricted to fewer people. A community is low on a respect scale if common courtesy is withheld from large groups of people on account of their political attitudes. If people are rude to others because they think their wealth and position gives them that right, or because they don't like a man's race, or his religion. Equal opportunity for all citizens to develop useful skills is one basis for rating a community on a respect scale. The opportunity to develop useful skills is important, but not enough. The equally important opportunity to put skills to use is a further test on a respect scale. A power scale is another important yardstick of despotism. It gauges the citizen's share in making the community's decisions. Communities which concentrate decision-making in a few hands rate low on a power scale and are moving towards despotism. Like France under the Bourbon kings, one of whom said, "The state, I am the state." Today, democracy can ebb away in communities whose citizens allow power to become concentrated in the hands of bosses.
What I say goes, see? I'm the law around here.
The test of despotic power is that it can disregard the will of the people. It rules without the consent of the governed. Look beyond the legal formalities of an election in measuring a community on the power scale to see if the ballot is really free. If the citizens can vote only the way they're told, a community approaches despotism. When legislatures become ceremonial assemblies only and have no real control over lawmaking, their community rates low on a power scale. In a downright despotism, opposition is dangerous whether the despotism is official or whether it is unofficial.
The spread of respect and power in a community is influenced by certain conditions, which many observers measure by means of the economic distribution and information scales.
If a community's economic distribution becomes slanted, its middle income groups grow smaller, and despotism stands a better chance to gain a foothold.